I'm Christian Lukens, District 6.
And I'm Jim Medina, District 7.
And this is a Caltrans News Flash. We're here at District 7's Lebeque Maintenance Station, just off of Interstate 5, about 60 miles north of Los Angeles, 40 miles south of Bakersfield, at the 4,100-foot summit of Tejon Pass. During periods of heavy snowfall at this elevation, the freeway is temporarily shut down under a venture coordinated between CHP and Caltrans known as Operation Snowflake.
This is a key freeway corridor, widely known as the Grapevine, connecting Southern California to the Central Valley.
I'm here with Officer Anthus of Fort Tejon CHP. Tell the people about what goes into the closures. What are the different phases that you have to go through? What are you looking for when the closures are necessary?
Well, prior to the closures, we're watching the weather, and we expect snow. We start getting extra bodies in place. We start communicating with Caltrans. When it does start snowing, then when it becomes dangerous, we slow people down. We start doing paces up and over the Grapevine where we run what we call round robins. Then we shut it down, clear the roadway, let Caltrans handle their business and make it safe again.
Randy, can you describe some of the equipment you used during Operation Snowflake?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we have two pieces right here. This is actually going to be our snowcat. When things get bad, this is our all-terrain vehicle. It gets us around when the trucks can't get around. And then this is probably one of our more standard pieces for the highway. Actually, when we're out on the highway with this one, we can clear two lanes at one time.
Mike, how's the Operation Snowflake? What is the process that you go through? I know you help coordinate it.
Let's say there's a chance of snow to come down. So I keep an eye on it. I monitor it. We use different weather stations. As soon as I see that it's predicted at 4,500 feet, that's when I basically call Operation Snowflake.
Now we have a new addition this year with the gate at Castaic. Can you explain a little bit how that works?
So what this is going to do actually, so instead of funneling just to the right, we can open up that gate and funnel to the left also and put them right back onto the freeway. So hopefully that'll relieve some of that congestion.
Yeah. Well, Mike, we appreciate all the work the maintenance crews do. It's very vital. Thanks a lot.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you.
I'm Christian Lukens.
And I'm Jim Medina. And this has been a Caltrans News Flash.